While releasing the report, Deposit Protection Fund Chief Executive Officer Julia Claire Olima Oyet noted that the DPF posted 15% growth in total assets. The growth was mainly on account of an increase in investments in Government of Uganda Treasury bills and bonds.
Investment is driven by our focus on ensuring that we balance between capital preservation, having enough liquidity, and also posting some return to the fund. And this is important because we need to have adequate funds to be able to pay depositors in that unlikely event that the bank is closed and the Bank of Uganda calls us as the DPF to compensate our depositors.
She asserted that the fund registered an increase in deposits.
Development reflects, amongst others, that public confidence in the financial sector is growing steadily, thanks to the concerted efforts of the various sector players, DPF.
Oyet highlighted the achievements recorded by the fund, including the rolling out of the depositor payout and premium management system.
Developed, and now we're rolling out an IT payout system, which will enable the fund to pay depositors swiftly and very conveniently using various modes of payment like the mobile money phones and any others.
Balam Sempala, the director IT, gave an insight on the new system, saying the DPF will work together with telecom companies and NERA to develop the new system.
First of rolling down the system, the rest of the contributing institutions, we have already rolled out to about four of them, and those were the ones we worked with during the implementation.
One of the key things we are guided on is that we should ensure that the value of the assets or the funds we have is able to grow in line with inflation. And so we are required to preserve capital as much as possible.
This year marked the start of the second five-year strategic plan, which spans from 2022 to 2027. This strategic focus of the new plan is to double the fund size for improved coverage, automate various internal processes, and continue conducting public awareness across the country. The Deposit Protection Fund joins the financial landscape to contribute to financial sector stability and ensure that protected deposits are paid in time in the event of failure of contributing institutions, hence building public confidence in the financial sector. Story by Sharon Nawasirie for the news.